kepada para hadirin sekalian, sebagaimana tadi kami himbau agar
competition. Malaysia, the winners on five separate occasions, and indeed the honour of being both the first ever champions and now the holders. Indonesia, the most successful team in the history of the Thomas Cup, having lifted the trophy a record eight times. This evening's match, a repeat of the last Thomas Cup final played 2 years ago in Kuala Lumpur. That match produced the excitement and euphoria that is hard to forget. But not to be outdone, the packed stadium here in Jakarta already vibrating to the singing and cheering of the enthusiastic crowd. Can the Indonesian men emulate the ladies who regained the Uber Cup, the women's competition, in a thrilling match here last night? The first match on court, reigning All England champion, Indonesia's Hariyanto Arbi against Malaysian hero Rashid Sidek. Join us after the break for the start of this match.
Thank you.
welcome back live to Jakarta, the Thomas Cup final for 1994. Indonesia, Hariyanto Arbi just crosses himself against Malaysia's Rashid Sidek. With me in the commentary box, Sanjay Sharma, former captain of the Indian badminton team. Sanjay, and in a very exciting prospect of a match in front of us. Your predictions?
Very difficult, really, Julian, to predict this time. A little bit of statistics, perhaps, for the so-inclined. These two teams, of course, have met five times in the finals, and this is the sixth meeting. Indonesia have won twice. The first match here can turn out to be extremely crucial. The surprise, of course, is that Indonesians have rested Joko Suprianto, the world champion. The reason being that Rashid has always been comfortable against Joko. Hariyanto, on the other hand, has defeated Rashid six times out of nine that they have played, including the last three times continuously, and twice of them in Kuala Lumpur. It will be a test of great strength of mind and character for Rashid to be able to bring this first point for Malaysia. But I have a feeling that it will be the second match, that is the first men's doubles, that would decide the way this tide turns. The predictions at the outset, I feel that Indonesia may take this 4-1, but as the evening unrolls, I'm sure there may be a lot of surprises ahead for us.
Rashid Sidek, 25-year-old Malaysian number one. But the involvement of the crowd here in Istora Stadium, Jakarta, already at a very high pitch. To the memorable win at the last Thomas Cup finals. Very, very early stages in this game. 1-1.
Something about the crowd though, Julian. I think half the people here are standing, and I only hope that in case Hariyanto is not able to take an early lead for the first game, we do not see the scenes that were there in 1967. When the finals had to be abandoned. But of course, a lot of security here tonight and a good match in prospect.
1-0.
Of Korea clearly running out of breath in the first game itself. Do you feel this is the correct tactics employed by Indonesia to play him in the first match itself?
Well, it's always a tricky one, but there's an awful lot to be said for psychological advantage. And as you say, Hariyanto Arbi has won their last three encounters, and I'm sure that must have been the deciding factor in the selection decision.
Anticipated this extremely well, but Rashid also has to keep in mind that Arbi has got this extraordinary capability of twisting his body and hitting either a smash on either flanks or a fast flat toss, which can be very, very deceptive. If Rashid can read the stroke, he can really get back into the game.
Enormous leap in the air to hit the jump smash. Again, he's looking to come into the net so quickly.
Time
8-4.
4-8.
Rashid, of course, Julian, if you have been following his career, has played some of the best matches of the game in Kuala Lumpur. Never really a great player outside, and he has been likened to the village champion by the Indonesian supporters. They call him Jago Kampung. Let us hope that he storms Jakarta. At least that's the hope of Rashid, whether he will, for the first time, do away with this title that the Indonesians have given him.
Brilliant play. Arbi Arbi jump smashing, up he goes. He follows it in, another smash. Just so aggressive. Of course, when he's leaping that high in the air, he's able to bring the shuttle down even steeper. Hariyanto Arbi, of course, reigning All England champion. 23-year-old. Body.
10-5. 5-10.
Arbi would be looking for the same victory, same sort of victory that he had in the All England this year. In the quarterfinals, he beat Rashid 15-1, 15-5. And he has started off in a great fashion indeed.
6-10.
Court. 10-6. Brilliant. Really the key to it, taking the shuttle early at the net. Arbi able to come in and just flick the shuttle cross court. Last time, he varies it. really needing to find some inspiration here.
Of that shot when he jumps up, as we see now, this time to the cross court, next time down the line, sometimes that fast toss. That's where Rashid is being beaten, not yet anticipating it as well as he used to.
13-6. Welcome back to Jakarta. Hariyanto Arbi of Indonesia just secured the opening game by 15-6. He's just toweling down, changing his shirt before the start of the second. Really, this crowd here, very, very enthusiastic and involved.
One only hopes that they remain enthusiastic, because there seems to be a bit of tension in the crowd. There are so many of them standing in places that at any given time something could happen. And I'm sure Roger Johansson, the chief referee, seems to be also a very worried man. That's the wife of the Malaysian Prime Minister on the screen as we start the second game.
Second game from Rashid Sidek. Really didn't spend enough time in the first game trying to command the rally and dictate the pace. Hariyanto Arbi, Indonesia's heroic All England champion, really dictating the pace. their usual reaction whenever Rashid Sidek takes the shuttle to serve. They're booing, they're trying to put him off. And at the moment, it appears as if they're achieving their goal. Just out. Sidek, unsure what to do at the moment. Hariyanto Arbi from Indonesia controlling the rallies at will.
I think Rashid really has to fight two battles here. One is with the crowd and one is with Hariyanto. And he seems not to be getting an upper hand in either one of them. Even the finals in Kuala Lumpur never had this sort of roar from the crowd.
Hariyanto Arbi again leaping in the air. My goodness, he can bring that shuttle down steeply. But a great smash from Rashid Sidek. Broke his racket with the power of that smash. Just leaves the court to get a new racket. Very tightly strung rackets, the strings nowadays, Sanjay.
Very tightly indeed. Almost 21 pounds to 22 pounds, I'm told. In fact, what I was saying was that was the first positive smash that Rashid was able to hit in this match so far. Perhaps an indication of things to come. Perhaps he's just about reading Arby's game.
The score stuck on love two. It's at this moment that Rashid really must play himself into this match. Love. Suprianto, Arbi having an extraordinary run back in 1993. He started the year by winning the Chinese Taipei Masters, then the Japan Open, then the All England. In fact, he was undefeated until the World Championships in May. Again, the speed and athletic play of Hariyanto Arbi really proving decisive. Five love.
Love five. One five.
The mistake from Arbi gives Rashid his first point in this second game.
That was a good service, very deep service indeed. Rashid has not really been able to play the shuttle right to the baseline, and that has been giving Arbi all the time to jump up and hit those smashes. But at that time, we saw he was not prepared to jump. The moment he jumps, that has the shuttle has to be in the midcourt or somewhere around the midcourt to get that angle.
Rashid Sidek, of course, coached by the former world champion Yang Yang. Well, some of those people in the crowd look a bit precarious to me.
Such a fine variation to his smashes when he leaps. Rashid is not able to decide till the last moment where to turn, where to move, indeed, where to anticipate. Really been some blistering smashes from Hariyanto, the jumping jack of badminton.
Service
fault called. Service judge. Determining that Hariyanto Arbi had moved his feet while serving.
Incidentally, the service judge, one of the finest badminton umpires from India, Sudhakar, a great moment also for him to have the honor. of umpiring in this 1994 Thomas Cup Finals.
I really feel that Rashid Sidek needs to have the courage to be a bit more aggressive. Rashid Sidek has managed to lift one of Hariyanto Arbi's smashes. To cope in this situation?
Well, he certainly had in Kuala Lumpur 2 years back, but since then he has not really been the player he was. And in Kuala Lumpur he played in badminton of his life. I don't think I have seen him winning matches from a very big deficit indeed, and this is one of them. I have my doubts if he would now be able to come back into this match, unless of course Arbi gives him some early points through some errors.
Rashid Sidek of course had an eye operation last year, and since then, as you say, really not found the same sort of form as he showed in the last Thomas Cup. Signs maybe that Rashid is willing to try and up the pace of this game. Up till now, Hariyanto Arbi has played very fast and very furious badminton, and Rashid has been unable to cope. The signs are there that Rashid realizes that he must be more aggressive in his play.
Rashid also has to come in when he comes to the net. He has to take the opportunity to really tap the shuttle down on the first given chance, as Arbi has been able to do. Once the shuttle is high, and if he's going to take it low as he has been taking, he's immediately giving the opportunity to Arbi to go into the attack.
A hard, powerful beautiful smash into the body. Yet again, the winner. Almost appearing to leap from the mid-court all the way back to hit that smash. Nice shot from Rashid Sidek.
5-10.
To hit a shot cross court. So important to be on balance. Of course, the cross court shots almost a make or break in several instances. If your opponent gets the shuttle back, you've got the full court diagonal of the court to cover. Arbi serving 10-5. The push from the net from Arbi, just too flat. Sanjay, the serve clearly not the full length of the court. It's called in.
This indeed is a very desperate moment now for Rashid. If he has to get back into this match, it has to be now. Otherwise, it will be too late.
Just going off to towel down.
That service out indeed telling the story of this match. Whenever he's playing short of length, Arbi just hammers it down at will at any angle, and when he plays deep, the chances always of the shuttle sailing out.
It is over. 5-11.
I think that's the first time in the match that Rashid Sidek has taken a shuttle off the top of the tape and made a killing shot. Really should have been trying to do that earlier in this match. Lovely disguised drop shot from Hariyanto Arbi. Enjoying the moment.
5-11.
Smashed and outmaneuvered in this first singles match against Hariyanto. It really has been his reluctance going to attack, I think, that has been the undoing so far.
Again, the service long. But Hariyanto Arbi doing exactly the same thing. Rashid needing to lift his head and keep fighting.
Seven, 13.
It's out. It's match points. brave from Rashid Sidek. Shuttle only just landing out. Arbi always going for the adventurous shot. Arbi just asking for the court to be mopped. Perspiration on the court surface makes it very slippy indeed.
I really doubt if the air conditioning here is making any difference. So many people, very humid situation indeed for both the players.
Brilliant drop shots. Now can Hariyanto Arbi give Indonesia a one love lead in this Thomas Cup final? Seem to try and will the shuttle out. Just showing signs of tiredness. They want their man to finish his match off.
Okay, thank you.
Rashid just changing the shuttle. Arbi taking his time. 14. That's it! He leaps in the air! Hariyanto Arbi has taken the match!
calon pemain.
Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to introduce the first double between Indonesia and Malaysia.
Hadirin sekalian, wasit yang akan memimpin pertandingan ini adalah Hakan Bosko dari Swedia. Hakim servis Michael Kirk dari Inggris.
Service judge Michael Gill of England.
Para pemain dari Malaysia, Cheah.
Prime Sports, Hariyanto Arbi has just taken Indonesia into the lead in this Thomas Cup final. His win over Rashid Sidek by 15-6, 15-11. Indonesia really could not ask for a better start.
Absolutely right, Gillian. A dream start. An easy first match victory for the Indonesians. Rashid Sidek, hero of the last Thomas Cup for Malaysia, not in the game. Not allowed to play his game in this singles. Hariyanto into attack all the time. Great variations of smashes, great variations of strokes. Never really allowed Rashid to dominate the game at any given time, except for the 2 points in between 14-7 to 14-10. That was about the only time where RB was playing a little slow and Rashid trying to get back into the match. Otherwise, it was RB all the way.
Well, the next match on court, the players already knocking up. The first men's doubles, Rudy Gunawan and Bambang Suprianto against Cheah and Pitt and Subian Kang. Join us after the break for the start of this match. Welcome back live to Jakarta.
Yes,
the second match in this 1994 Thomas Cup final, Malaysia against Indonesia. The players on court, Malaysia represented by Cheah Sun Kit and Subian Kang. Indonesia represented by Bambang Suprianto and Rudy Gunawan. The Malaysian boys, Cheah Sun Kit and Subian Kang, of course, the heroes of the hour during the last Thomas Cup final in Kuala Lumpur. It was their match. They were playing at second men's doubles on that occasion. It was their match that clinched the cup for Malaysia. But now, 2 years later, they're playing at number one men's doubles position. Their opponents today, Rudy Gunawan, who's just walking onto court, nearest to camera, the tall Indonesian boy, reigning world champion, silver medalist in the Olympic Games at men's doubles. Rudy Gunawan.
Malaysia represented by Cheah, Beng, Kiang.
Always anticipates the game very well.
All right, Indonesia,
always looking to go forward.
Bambang,
will try and command the rally.
It's interesting to note, Gillian, how this combination, this partnership came about. Rudy Gunawan, of course, used to partner Eddie Hartono till the Olympic Games. And then Eddie Hartono retired. Bambang started as a singles player, had a horrific accident as he was coming to Kuala Lumpur in the last Thomas Cup to spar with his teammates. But he cut off, sliced off rather, a bit of his right-hand thumb, the hand that he plays with, and after that he started thinking to play doubles, and in fact this is how this competition came together, and they have done extremely well. I believe they have won the All England Championship this year, and as against Cheah Sukit, Beng, Kiang, they have played them three times and have beaten them all the three times, including the semi-finals at the All England of this year.
Indonesian pair nearest to camera, the Malaysian boys.
One love, second server.
Bambang Suprianto to serve. Great interception from Bambang. Two love. But the Malaysian Subiang Kang to serve and serves into the net. Cheah Sun Kits just smiles at his partner, tries to relax.
One, two,
opening game of this men's doubles. Rudy Gunawan just controlling the rally from the back of the court, keeping the shuttle going down. Looking very nervous indeed at the start of this match. A good play from Subiang Kang. Took control of the net. Rudy Gunawan just asked to change the shuttle and to towel down. The players not really settled into this match yet. It's still very early stages. Indonesians just 3-1 up in the first game. rally, really set up by a great return of serve from Subiang Kang. 1-3. 2-3. Cheers and Kit. Scores level.
This, of course, a very crucial match as far as the Malaysians are concerned. They will be keeping in mind that in the semi-finals, Bambang and Rudy Gunawan had three games with the Korean pair of Yoo Young Sang and Kim Dong Moon. They would be looking to try at least extend these people, this Indonesian pair, in the first game itself, take it to the setting, and then, being younger, try to tie them out and get this match for Malaysia. Otherwise, there will be a great amount of pressure on the Malaysians.
Well taken, Malaysia.
4-3.
Bang Bang Suprianto really a little weak in his defense at the moment. The Malaysian boys smiling at each other.
Su Beng Kiang, so effective at the net. If they can just continue this, they will indeed get a lot more points.
Six, three.
This Indonesian combination, Julian, Rudy and Bambang, both of them have this hesitation of really rushing into the net, as do Rexy and Ricky, who are always on the lookout of hitting and moving fast into the net. Su Beng Kiang does this for Malaysia. That could well be the deciding factor.
I think you're absolutely right. Rudy, out of the two of the Indonesian boys, is the more likely to go and try and dominate the net area, but certainly not as fast as Subiang Kang. Knowing which one to take the smash. Rudy Gunawan not playing the net shot. Clear is out.
4-6, second server.
4-6.
Second server, 6-4. second server.
Welcome back. The serve with the Indonesians. Rudy Gunawan, 4-6 down in the first game.
Second time that he was flicked. I think it's his eagerness to attack as early as possible that is forcing him to stay a little bit forward than he should. Rudy Gunawan making use of those opportunities to get two easy points.
Doubles champion, won the title
with
Ricky Subadja. But now he's playing with Bambang Suprianto. Finding his form at the net so far. Welcome back to Jakarta. The Indonesian pair, Rudy Gunawan and Bambang Suprianto, just ease into the lead, 8-7. Bambang really not getting behind that shuttle. He was off balance when he tried to hit the smash.
Seven,
Pearson Kitts changes the shuttle. Mouse at the moment as to who can stay on the attack the longest. Eight all. Almost silence from the crowd every time Malaysia win a point. It's out. Su Ban Kang knows he must bring the shuttle down steeply, playing from that end of the court. There is a drift in this hall. It is definitely faster hitting the shuttle towards the camera end. That Indonesia score a point. Cheer. Malaysians taking the opportunity to just towel down and take a few minutes to compose themselves. Indonesian pair, Grand Prix finals title holders. Shot. He takes it early, deceptive, it hits the top of the tape and just falls over. Suprianto. Great defensive play from the Indonesians, but not quite good enough. The relentless pressure from the Malaysian boys. The Malaysians have the service back. Bambang just anxiously looks at his racket.
seems to be a lot of shuttle changes, Julian. Do you think it ever has been so high in a men's doubles match?
Well, I really don't know, but I think all the men out on court at the moment have very hard smashes. And the shuttles just not able to stand up to their power. 9-13. Perhaps Rudy Gunawan should have tried to intercept that drive. Bang Bang having to cover a lot of court. Suprianto from Indonesia, 13-10. Rudy Gunawan forced to take the defensive shot on his forehand. Doesn't often play that, prefers to play a backhand defense. Still very much in the fight. But their cause won't be helped by a serve into the net. Rudy, the most experienced player on court. But the Malaysian combination also vast experience. Smashes out.
Over, 10-13.
A golden opportunity for the Indonesian combination to smash that one down. But didn't hit it steep enough.
This was in fact the third time that the two Indonesians had a service on 13-10. A bit of nerves perhaps being stuck at 13 for such a long time.
Good play from Indonesia.
10-13, second serve.
Cheers and Kit. Very good to see both pairs trying to get on the attack right from the start of the rally. And then Suprianto's play at the net takes the Indonesians to game points.
Hock.
service, fault called. Mike Jilks from England, the service judge.
14-10, second serve.
But Rudy Gunawan still has the serve for Indonesia. And they take the game on their second match point. Bambang Suprianto and Rudy Gunawan take the opening game by 15-10. Welcome back to Jakarta, the first men's doubles match in this Thomas Cup final. The opening game, Bambang Suprianto and Rudy Gunawan won the first game 15-10 against Cheah and Kit and Subian Kang from Malaysia. As you can see, the crowd highly involved in Istora Stadium here in Jakarta. The Indonesian boys have just changed their shirts. They're ready for the second game. Love all.
Love all.
Ooh, Bang Bang broke the strings of his racket with that smash.
One love.
The Malaysians would be looking to push Bambang, I think, on the attack. Basically, a singles player turned into a doubles specialist. He is the weak link. He doesn't have so much of experience. If only they can turn the tables on Bambang, they will have a bit of a chance. But that also means keeping away the vastly experienced and perhaps the most successful doubles player right now, Rudy Gunawan, out of this game as much as they can. That's the only chance I feel the Malaysians have. So they have this early three-love lead. It has been the Indonesian pair very much in the driver's seat for the time being.
Well, maybe a little reaction to having won the opening game, the Indonesian pair maybe lost their concentration and focus a little bit.
Four love, second server.
Love
Love, four, second server.
Welcome back. The Malaysians still 4-love up in the second game. And really, the Indonesians at the start of this second looking all out of sorts. 5-love. Better play from the Indonesians. First time in this second game, they've really tried to attack.
Bambang there.
Six, love, second serve.
Losing the side of the shuttle because of his tall partner in front. He was hesitant, thinking that Rudy would hit. And gave the point. Service fault. Racket clearly out above the waist. Jillian Cheah Sunkit has the same problem. 2 days back when we were watching him, a lot of service faults on that occasion as well in the semi-finals.
That's right, and I'm quite surprised that in his practice sessions between then and now, he hasn't had a jolly good look at his service together with his coaches to try and sort out that service fault problem.
Because this thing can really unnerve the player who's serving because he's always under pressure.
Nice, delicate control from the Indonesians. Six. It's out.
Serves over. 6-2.
Rudy Gunawan really trying an overambitious shot. Beng Kiang.
Seven, two.
That was a better service.
Seven, two.
It's a great return of serve. Must have landed right on the line. Malaysians really coming forward now and maintaining the attack. But having said that, Cheah Sunkit immediately flicks serve and puts himself on the defense. Indonesian pair really don't seem to be working together at the moment. Look like two individuals on court. Unusual because they're a very experienced pair together and a very successful pair together.
Exactly. I feel it's the reason really is that they have given away this big lead in the second game. They were a bit relaxed when they started the second game after winning the first, and that is one thing they should have been very careful about. But as the match progresses, we'll see whether they have been able to sort out this problem. The other thing, of course, is that Suprianto here has been playing so correctly and so nicely on the net. He has been putting all sorts of pressures over them, and that's the one they have to save.
Indonesia regain control of the net. Disappointing from their point of view that they didn't make more of that situation. They attacked well but couldn't finish it off. Just asking to change the shuttle. The crowd didn't like that. But it really shouldn't be a problem to change the shuttle. Side. 5-8. Oh, it's just out the side.
Server 8-5.
Of the play we saw from the Indonesians in the first game. Very sharp on that net. Just out. Service back with the Indonesians. 5-10. They really haven't been serving so well either in this second game. Cross court, lovely. Seems to me that Rudy Gunawan really is very nervous. He's usually devastating when the shuttle comes up like that, but completely mistiming it.
Yes, I think he was a bit out of position as well. He never expected the shuttle to come that easily, and that never gave him the chance to be in position to go for a kill. Perhaps if he had just lifted it up and gone into defense.
11-6.
The Malaysians seem to be running away with this second game, 11-6, and the Indonesians not really able to control. Su Beng Kiang on the net, he's taken a lot of points, moves in very sharply indeed.
Good smash from Bambang.
11-6, second server.
Yeah.
man, Rudy Gunawan. Little slow over there. He never expected that flick service. Was in all sorts of problems. Had to take it very late. And Cheah Soon Kit just correct position to block it.
Serve server, 6-12.
Well, despite the deficit, I just somehow feel if the Indonesians could find their rhythm. But really, at the moment, it's the Indonesians that are losing the rally rather than the Malaysians winning the rally.
They just cannot afford to lose services like that. Doubles services are so vital. There again, Subang Kiang doing the same mistake.
It's out. Malaysians 13-6, just 2 points from the second game. Now it's game point.
14, game point, 6, second server.
It's in, it's well in, and the Malaysians have taken the second game by 15-6.
A lot of people are jumping down there, and I think,
oh, yeah.
See, on these terraces and moving into this arena.
4 minutes, ready.
See, one more guy.
Yeah.
Two.
Yeah.
I don't think the police really know about this.
Welcome back. A stunned silence in Istora Stadium here in Jakarta. The Indonesian crowd cannot believe that Rudy Gunawan and Bambang Suprianto could lose that second game 15-6, having taken the opening game fairly comfortably by the score of 15-10. The players just returning to court for the third and final game. And really, Sanjay, if you had been the Indonesian coach, what words of advice would you have given the boys during that 5 minute break?
Well, they have made a lot of mistakes at the net, Julian, especially Bambang. He's coming into the net at the right time, but somehow not been able to control the shuttle at that position. And that's what I would advise them. The problem really has been for both of them. If you go back into the partnership of Rudy Gunawan and Eddie Hartono, it used to be Eddie Hartono who used to play the net. Rudy was a baseline player. Bambang, being a singles player, is also more of a baseline player. Both of them go to the net, but are not really comfortable, and that's one area they have to really try to control.
That was a beautiful cross-court block, and Bang Bang followed it in well. Little jump at the end, delighted with himself. Bang Bang, Suprianto. Great shot from Bang Bang. Defended well. Took the defense. Followed it into the net.
Seems to be all fired up, Bang Bang. Playing the correct game at the start of this third and the final game of this second match in this evening tonight.
Good return of serve.
Round one, second serve.
Attack the short serve. And so did Rudy Gunawan. One love. The Indonesians, even in these early stages in the third game, certainly looking a lot more positive. Subian Kang, the Malaysian left-hander, playing the shuttle so quickly, keeping the pace of the game very high. Obviously feels that pace into Bang Bang, into his body, is the right tactic. Brilliant play. That's again, he was relentless. Smash, smash, and finally the third smash to win the rally.
Crowd is all fired up again in anticipation. Will Rudy Gunawan and Bambang give Indonesia this second point in this very crucial first doubles match?
Gunawan, three love. Second server, bang bang to serve, for love. Good play from the Malaysians. Cheers and kicks. The Malaysian pair, runner-up in the World Championships in Birmingham in 1993.
Love four, second serve.
Love four. Really attacking the short serve so well, putting the Malaysians under enormous pressure right from the start of the rally. Despite his size, Rudy Gunawan very agile across the net. Bang.
the music coming to an abrupt stop. As soon as the Indonesians lose their serve, a very tricky situation for Beng Kiang and Cheah Sunkit. They gave the victorious point to Malaysia and Kuala Lumpur 2 years back. Jillian, can they do it now? Can they really bring themselves up? You have seen them play in Europe recently. Do they have something left in their armory to really bring this match alive now?
Well, I think that's all dependent on whether they can serve well. And from that service, the answer is no. The shuffle, probably an attempt to try and calm the situation. Seven-one, so important in a third game to change ends at eight with a good lead. Defensive qualities tested to the full. I'm a little bit surprised the Malaysians were concentrating their attack on him.
I think they had the shuttle nearer to Gunawan when they started that attack, and he seemed to be a bit out of position after lifting every attack. The big man, very muscular, very strong, very tall indeed, just giving away that point again on the flick service of Cheah Sunkit. He has this little problem nowadays to rush back to smash a flick service. Not so much of Bambang.
Really have played themselves back into this match.
Rudy Gunawan also has this problem of sweating a lot, and one only hopes that he doesn't get too dehydrated in this very humid conditions. A stadium that is packed to the capacity, perhaps a bit more, and I'm told almost 5,000 people have gone away without being able to get tickets to come and witness this great moment in Jakarta.
Gunawan very slow to get back to return the flick serve. I have to say, I think he's looking a little tired. Maybe his stamina in question. Have done well. They were 7-love down in this third game. It's now 6-7.
This of course tells us that in doubles a big lead is not clearly going to take you to victory. A lead is only as good as the standard of your opponents. The moment they get an upper hand, you can easily get 4 to 5 points on a roll, as the Malaysians have done now. From love 7 to 6-7, an entire dramatic reversal of fortunes.
That's a great shot. That will give the Indonesians encouragement. They change ends ahead. It's a great defensive shot. Bang Bang using all the strength in his wrist to flick that shuttle deep into the forehand corner.
The Malaysians have looked a little more perky, a little more swift while negotiating the court. And if they continue with the same speed, I feel that the match is not really over as far as they are concerned.
Experience to finish off this match. Indonesians beginning to look edgy again. Second game, the Indonesians also hit a lot of smashes into the net. Chose the spots and placed it there. 7. Chatting with Bang Bang, talking tactics. Cheers and kits. Second server. Safe and secure when he's making his kills. 8-11. To his backhand side. There was a big gap down his forehand, and that's where Cheah Sun Kit placed the shuttle. Oh my word! The Swedish umpire has called a fault receiver. The receiver, of course, not allowed to move before the service has been struck. What a crucial, critical moment for that to happen. Certainly the decision has delighted the Indonesian crowd.
And I really suspect that Cheah Sun Kit knew that he was committing himself to move before the service, because there was not a word of murmur from him.
Back with the Malaysians. it down.
Presentation to Titus.
Welcome back to Prime Sports for live coverage of the Thomas Cup final here in Jakarta. Indonesia now in a 2-love lead over Malaysia. They've taken the opening singles and now the first men's doubles. Have Malaysia the character or the players to come back from this?
Extremely difficult situation as far as Malaysia is concerned. Of course, Ong Yu Hock coming in for this second singles match. A very exuberant character indeed, short, but with a heart, a real giant heart, a great fighter on the court. But he is going to play against Ardy, the former world number one, the former All England champion. In the last meeting was at the All England this year, where Ardy had defeated Ong Yu Hock in the quarterfinals. Ong Yu Hock has to take out something from his bag, something from what his coaches have told him. Yang Yang and Chen Chanji, the great former Chinese champions, world champions, now coaching in Malaysia, of course. And Punch Gunalan, the man who did so much for Malaysia last time. The scenes I still remember I witnessed in 1984 when Indonesia won the last Thomas Cup, defeating China. And all the players kneeling on the ground, weeping, praying to God. And I suspect we are close to that scene again. Indonesia seemed to be in the driver's seat, 2-0 up, and a very good chance of taking this third singles if we go by current forms. That is, of course, if only Ong Yu Hock can work a miracle here for Malaysia.
Ardy Wiranata, the Indonesian player, also Olympic silver medalist. And in badminton's first ever Olympic Games in 1992 in Barcelona. As you say, these players have played each other before. Both have similar styles, both retrieve the shuttle very well. They're both very fast around the court. But giving all the past results and the situation here in Jakarta with the amount of support that Ardy is going to have, unless Ardy freezes and really gets so tied up with nerves, I think I have to agree with you. Ardy Wiranata has to be the favourite in this match. And of course, if he were to win this singles, it would all be over. The Thomas Cup final, the best of five rubbers. Indonesia, two love up at the moment. Just need a third rubber to secure the Thomas Cup.
I think that we will be witnessing really a great defensive confrontation between these two players. Not very tall, but two single specialists, extremely good at keeping the shuttle in play for a long, long time. Good length, good control, always waiting for the opponent to commit a mistake. And talking of the Olympics, as Julian just pointed out, one more thing I would like to add was that this great game of badminton was viewed on television by more than 1.2 billion people. The semi-finals and finals of Barcelona Olympics. And I suspect the same amount of people must be viewing this championships around the world, wherever Prime Sports is taking this coverage live. As we see them warming up, Ong Yu Hock was a reserve last time the Malaysians played in Kuala Lumpur. This time, of course, he has been upgraded to the number two position in front and ahead of the great fighter Fu Kok Kiong. But the way things have gone, Fu Kok Kiong may not have much to decide. Ardy Wiranata, highly experienced, the man who really brought Indonesia back into a reckoning as a world power when all the greats like Rudy, Lim Swee King, Ichuk had retired and the Chinese were dominating this game.
Indeed, Ardy Wiranata's first claim to fame was here in Istora Stadium in 1989 when he reached the final of the World Championships men's singles event. Since then, as you say, he's led Indonesia's challenge back to supremacy in world badminton.
And he lost that one very crucial match of his career, that first singles last time that they played in the finals, Indonesia and Malaysia, in the Thomas Cup. And I'm very sure that Ardy would like to wipe out that defeat from his career by giving Indonesia the victory in this Thomas Cup finals.
Players now ready to commence this second men's singles match. Underway. And he gets it off in a very positive fashion and has to have a smile to himself at the reaction of the crowd.
Joker in the pack, always smiling, a great company for the normally very serious looking Malaysian teammates.
Wiranata, All England champion back in 1991, won so many titles around the world. Service back, 3-1. Thank you.
to rally.
I think the two players really testing and probing each other at the moment, testing each other's stamina. But the long rallies will continue.
But again, the Malaysian boy finds perfect touch with that drop shot. Despite the score only at 3-1 in the first game on New Hock, perspiring heavily and having to towel down. New Hawks best results, beating the Olympic champion Alan Buddy Kasuma in the group round of the World Cup last year. Lovely net shot from Ardy.
Of course, falling into that trap of not being able to concentrate in the long. Bambang really not being able to give a good length to the high lobs, and Ardy just bringing them down whenever there is the first chance.
It's out. As well. Wiranata, always so calm on court. Yeah. 8-5.
slow in his movement back there. Lovely play from the Malaysian on New Hock. A boo from the crowd. They don't like to see the Malaysian playing well. But Ardy Wiranata showing that he too can play the steep cross-court shots.
And he sliced that one. As we've seen this replay, sliced it very sharply, getting the pace of the shuttle, leaving no chance whatsoever for Ardy Hock.
On New Hock, going for more adventurous shots than he's used to. I think perhaps he's running out of ideas and trying to make winners early on. He must keep his patience if he wants to win this match. Ardy is so clever with his change of pace. Sometimes he's quite content to clear. Sometimes he's smashing and then he drops.
Stopping you from moving.
It's in. Misjudged by Ardy. He's not happy, but he certainly has a comfortable lead in this opening game. Ball then. 7-13. Positive about his play and looks as if he's prepared to attack more than normal.
Yes, he has been moving to the net a lot faster. The point before that he missed, of course, but correct position, correct stroke to play. But this time again, nicely pushing that on Ardy's body. There again we go. See that particular point? Ardy Hock building up nicely and moving in for the kill. See the last 3 points. It's been Ardy Hock waiting patiently, getting a chance to keep the shuttle down and then moving in swiftly to the net. It has brought him from 7-13 down and now on 11-13. Very critical moment for Ongi Hock and Malaysia.
Standstill.
32 years of age, born in Penang, now living in Kuala Lumpur. Oh my word. That cross-court slice drop from Ardy played to perfection. One love.
Smash.
trying the same tactics as Ardy. A good cross court, forehand smash deep into the court.
Seem to be letting it down. 11-2 on New York.
It's a miracle over here. Indonesia so very close to lifting the Yuba Cup after 10 years.
Ardy just using his experience, his
has had several serves on 13 and hasn't moved the score forward. Decides to have a quick drink, regather his thoughts.
Steadies himself to serve. points here. Incredible victory for Indonesia. Only the second time they have lifted now both the Thomas and Hugo Cup at the same time. 1975 was won, and this is now 1994. Great victory for Ardy, great victory for Indonesia. It was perhaps only delaying the inevitable. The crowd is settling down. A lot of things were thrown into the court at one stage, but a lot of control on the crowds.
Yes, the crowd's reaction here, quite incredible. We leave these scenes for a moment as we go to a break.
Saudara-saudara sekalian, kita telah menang. Harap tenang. Kita telah menang. Harap tenang. Jangan melempar sesuatu. Tolonglah. Jangan melempar sesuatu. Kami mohon dengan sangat. Kita telah menang. Silakan duduk.
Sebuah sebaik-baiknya bagaimana kita ketahui bahwa tim Thomas kami Indonesia kita telah berhasil menjadikan kami bahkan pada ikut Thomas kami Indonesia kita dapat menyanyikan bersama.
They're discussing there, they may not continue the further matches. That's what it looks like.
I think there's a big hoo-ha at the moment about
Indonesia,
whether they're going to continue playing or not. It's pointless. The Indonesian boys have come onto court. There really isn't any point. No. Are we going to do a roundup then?
Baiklah, para hadirin sekalian, akan kami panggil tim dari Indonesia. yang telah berhasil merebut piala emas dari tim Malaysia. Yang pertama-tama akan diserahkan medali emas kepada tim Indonesia oleh Ibu Suprianto. Penyerahan medali oleh Nyonya Sutrisno. Penyerahan bunga oleh Nyonya Suryadi. Penyerahan karangan bunga oleh Nyonya Suryadi. Kini kita laksanakan penyerahan piala Thomas Cup kepada tim Indonesia yang akan diserahkan oleh Ketua AIBF, Mr. Nyonya Lu Senlong. Penyerahan telah selesai. Kembali ke tempat dan terima kasih atas perhatiannya.